Hello friends, welcome to Kamat Astrology, and the topic we are going to cover today is understanding Jaimini Karakas from your horoscope. Om Guruve Namaha. Now the various concepts in Vedic Astrology have been illustrated by two sages. One is Sage Parashar and other is Rishi Jaimini. Okay. Parashar advocated the presence of natural Karakas, okay? That is, these Karakas are fixed regardless of any horoscope, okay? So what Parashar says is, Sun is the natural Karaka of father or soul. See, Karaka means significator, okay? So it does not mean Sun is your father, but what it means is Sun represents the universal soul or the universal father. Okay, and so any affliction to the sun in your horoscope also represents some impact on your father. Okay, so sun is the natural Karaka of the father or soul as per Rishi Parashar. Likewise, moon is the natural Karaka or significator of mother. Okay, Mars is the natural Karaka or significator of brother and property. Venus is the natural Karaka of marriage, that is, Shukra is the natural Karaka of marriage. Jupiter is the natural Karaka of children and spirituality, while Mercury is the natural Karaka of intellect, communication. Okay, and Shani obviously is the natural Karaka for grief, for your karma, for delays, and for strife. Okay. Now, what does Rishi Jaimini say? Rishi Jaimini accepts what Rishi Parashar says. Okay, he believes in the presence of natural Karakas. Okay, but he also adds that there is something called as Chara or movable Karakas. Okay, and these Karakas will vary for every horoscope. Okay, so Rishi Jaimini said that we have to consider 7 additional Karakas in addition to the natural Karakas while interpreting any horoscope. Okay, so the first Karaka which Rishi Jaimini says is the Atma Karaka, that is the planet having the highest longitude in your horoscope is the Atma Karaka, that is the significator of the self or the soul of that horoscope. Okay, the planet having the second highest longitude degree in your horoscope is called as the Amatya Karaka. Amatya Karaka is like a chief minister in a king's court, okay, and he is the significator of your career. Okay, all right. The planet having the third highest degree in terms of longitude is called as the Bhratri Karaka, that is the significator of siblings. Okay, and the planet having the fourth highest degree in terms of your longitude is called as the Matri Karaka or the significator of mother and education. Planet having the fifth highest degree is known as the Putri Karaka or the indicator of children, intelligence and creativity. The sixth Karaka is called Gnati Karaka, which is the significator of diseases, spiritual sadhana, struggle and strife. Okay, and the last Karaka is known as the Dara Karaka, which is the planet having the seventh highest degree in terms of longitude, and it is the significator of marriage, life partner and other business partnerships in general. So now we will take a sample horoscope and see how the Jaimini Karakas are arrived at for that horoscope. Now look at this sample horoscope. Okay, now in this horoscope, look at the planet having the highest degrees. Okay, so in the bottom corner of the screen, you will see a planet named as VE, which stands for Venus. Okay, Venus has the highest longitude, that is 26 degrees 15 minutes. Okay, all other planets have lesser longitude. So for this horoscope, the Atma Karaka becomes Venus. Okay, That is, Venus is the significator of the self or the soul of this horoscope, in addition to the natural significator, that is the Sun. Now look at the planet having the next highest degrees in the horoscope. So you can see that Mercury, represented by the letters ME, is at 25 degrees 33 minutes 28 seconds in the sign of Gemini. Okay, so Mercury is the second Jaimini Karaka or the Amatya Karaka or the significator of career in this horoscope. Okay, so Mercury is very important for the career of this person. Okay, because he is the Amatya Karaka. Look at the planet having the third highest degrees in the horoscope. Okay, so you can see Moon is located at 25 degrees 21 minutes. And Moon has the third highest degrees in the horoscope. So Moon is the Bhratri Karaka or the significator of brothers and sisters in this horoscope. Look at the planet having the fourth highest degree in the horoscope. So you can see Rahu and Ketu having 22 degrees 37 minutes, but you should ignore this, right? So Rahu and Ketu are not considered in the calculations. So take the next planet having the next highest degrees in the horoscope, and you will find that this is the Mars. Okay, planet Mars. Planet Mars is at 10 degrees 30 minutes. Okay, and this is the fourth Karaka or the significator of mother in the horoscope. It is the Matri Karaka. Okay. Next, look at which planet has the next highest degrees in the horoscope. It is the Sun, which is at 7 degrees 17 minutes 29 seconds. So Sun is the Pitri Karaka. Okay, that is the significator of children, intelligence and creativity. Look at the planet having the next highest degrees in the horoscope. You can see Jupiter or Guru at 6 degrees 34 minutes. Right? So this is the Gnati Karaka. Gnati Karaka is the significator of disease, strife and grief in the horoscope. Okay? So in this horoscope, you can see that Jupiter is very important while considering diseases, grief and strife. Okay? And look at the planet having the next highest degree, and that is Saturn, which is represented by the letters SA and is at 3 degrees 19 minutes. So Saturn is the seventh Karaka or the Dara Karaka. Okay, that is, Saturn is the significator of spouse in this horoscope. All right, so whenever you are considering marriage, partnerships, etc., you also have to look at Saturn in the horoscope. Okay. So this slide summarizes what we have just seen for the sample horoscope. So in the sample horoscope, Venus or Shukra is the Atma Karaka. Mercury is the planet with the second highest degrees, and so it is the Amatya Karaka in this horoscope. Moon is the planet with the third highest degrees, hence it is the Bhratri Karaka. Mangal or Mars is the planet with the fourth highest degrees. Hence, it is the Matri Karaka. Okay, and Sun is the planet with the fifth highest degrees. Hence, it is the Pitri Karaka, that is significator of children, intelligence and creativity. Jupiter or Guru has the sixth highest degrees. Hence, it is the Gnati Karaka, that is significator of disease and strife. And Saturn has the seventh highest degrees in the horoscope. So, it is also known as the Dara Karaka, or the significator of spouse, marriage and partnership in this horoscope. So whenever you are interpreting a horoscope, in addition to the natural Karaka, you must also give due importance to the Jaimini Karakas. Okay, the Jaimini Karakas are not fixed and they will vary from horoscope to horoscope. Rishi Jaimini says that in addition to the sthir or the fixed Karakas proposed by Parashar, okay, the Jaimini Karakas must also be given due importance when interpreting an horoscope. Okay, in fact, with Jaimini astrology, it is possible to interpret events accurately. Jaimini assumes that the signs, that is Aries to Pisces, have their own dashas. Okay, so he speaks about the dashas of signs rather than the dashas of planets. And he talks about signs aspecting each other rather than planets aspecting each other. Okay, so Jaimini and Parashar astrologies are two ways of arriving at the same result. Okay. So guys, this was what I wanted to tell you about Jaimini Karakas in Vedic astrology. Our contact details are given in this slide. So you can visit our website astroseva.tripod.com. If you want professional consulting, you can reach out to us through our mobile app on Google Play Store called Kamath Astrology. For any queries, feel free to write to me at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com. If you liked this video, please mark it as liked on YouTube. If you disliked it, please mark it as disliked. Feel free to subscribe to our channel Kamath Astrology on YouTube. The subscription is absolutely free and you will automatically get notified whenever I add a new video. So guys, thank you. Hope to see you soon.